Welcome back. In my last video, you may remember, I was automating between two different vocal modes, power lead and the light lead. And this video is going to be a continuation of that because it gets even better. Although it is a bit advanced, so you may want to watch just for curiosity. But if you are keen and follow along, you should be able to replicate this. First thing I want to do, though, is address a couple of things. One was there was some comments about the phase between them. I just used the section I was on, which was not necessarily the best place to line up the phase, because the more consonants that you have, the easier it is for it to actually line up the transients of the two signals. And if we do a little zoom in here of both of these files, you can see that getting the phase exactly right is never going to be possible because the loud performance and the soft performance are basically two different voices. See how this one, the phase is going up, and this one, the phase is going down, going up, and so on and so on. So as much as these are in the same shape in terms of start points of words and things, not all areas are going to crossfade perfectly. It's just the way it is. And there are a couple of things you can do to help, and I will show you that now. Step one, find a good spot where there's lots of consonants like K's and T's and, you know, things for it to actually hard sync to. So let's just do a quick one with this, and I will hit play and then analyze.
I never can say goodbye. No, 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 I never can.
Okay, so that thinks they're only three samples apart. And of course, what we're going to need to do now is go to the ratio and adjust that and see if that actually holds up. Let's go back to 50%. Okay.
I never can say goodbye. No, 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 I.
Yeah, it's not too bad. But just for fun, and since I'm trying to show you this, I'm going to go back to here and I'm going to increase the lengths to 8 seconds for both of them. Okay. And then I'll run a new analysis.
I never can say goodbye. No, 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 I never can say goodbye.
All right. Still three samples. Just for curiosity, I want to go to a different section and see if that stays true.
Is it so? Don't want to let you go. Hey, I never can say goodbye, boy. Oh, baby.
Okay, this is interesting. The inversion button popped on here, which means that it basically thinks that it's completely out of phase at some point during this chunk here. And so I'm just going to play this clip again here to see if what it sounds like. Don't forget, we're still 50-50 mix at the moment.
Is it so? Don't want to let you go. Hey, I never can say goodbye, boy.
Yeah. I still heard a little bit of phase going on.
I never can say goodbye. No, no.
I think we're fine with that, but you notice the time has changed here to 59 samples. So let's move this to here and do another analyze, but this time I'm going to use the advanced feature, which is spectral phase compensation. So I'll open both of those, make some room, and then enable them. And you can see I've done one before. And this will actually adjust the second signal's phase to work with the first one. So let's have a quick listen to see what this does.
Is it so? Don't want to let you go. Hey, I never can say goodbye, boy. Oh, baby.
Okay, let's have a listen back.
Is it so? Don't want to let you go. Hey, I
Interesting though, isn't it? This one's now got a delay of 57 samples and this one's zero, but the phase has been adjusted on this one. And there's still an issue on that one word in here, and I think that will always be the case. So best thing really, try and avoid that word, blending it. can't say more than that really. So there you go. So those are the advanced kind of features for getting the phase, the two tracks in phase. Now, the reason I'm doing this video is actually the more advanced kind of situation. The idea was that we have this ratio mixing between black side is the light voice and blue side is the power voice. We have the ratio being controlled by this multi-parameter. So I'm moving this one in order to automate it. And you see the ratio knob is being adjusted here. So as I move this, this blends between the quiet and the loud performance.
Every time I think I have had enough and start heading for the door, there's a very strange vibration piercing me right to the core.
So that's basically where we left off last time. And I have one I've got prepared earlier here because it's a little bit involved in getting it going. Just make this a bit bigger. And you may have already noticed there's another window lit up green here and it's saying mod 1. So I'm going to run this and there's no automation happening up here. I did not record any automation. Everything you're seeing right from when I hit play is happening in real time.
Every time I think I have had enough and start heading for the door, there's a very strange vibration piercing me right to the core. It says, turn around, you fool. You'll know you love him more and more. Tell me why.
So what's happening is I'm using this modulator to make the ratio animate. And I will show you how you do that. I'm going to turn this one off and go back to the one that doesn't have this already set up. The ratio set up, that's already in place. All I need to do is, same idea as before, I click on the hamburger, say clear and learn, move this for its full range, and then turn it off record, and you enable it here, and then we'll open the mod, and when I hit play, this will be driving the ratio.
I never can say
goodbye. Right, and I can change the shape.
No, 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 I...
Okay. So we want it on pitch. Put that back to zero. Not that that helps because this is controlling it. Right. We'll keep looking at this one though because that's where all the action is. There's a few things we need to set up. One is minimum maximum frequency. Now remember, we're going from zero to 100%. So there's no kind of correlation between actual pitch beyond frequencies here. We can't kind of choose, but we know where notes are, right? And we know that the bottom of her register is probably going to be around 200. So I'm going to put it at 200. And then max frequency, I'm going to put, say, at 1,000. And now this is just while we're getting things set up. Because the most important part is the detector. And the detector is where we actually say, same idea, we need to say minimum recognized and maximum recognized. Well, in this case, I'm going to do the same thing, really, 200. And 1,000, actually just go to 1,500. Pitch detection will leave on robust. Stabilization is how twitchy this will be moving, basically. So I'm going to crank that up a little bit. Let's go to 100 milliseconds. Still fast. I'll leave the speed as is. The detection accuracy, I think, will bring it down to like 50%. Because the higher the detection accuracy, the more twitchy it's going to be because unless the vocal is like, it's not like MIDI notes that are spot on every time. There's notes in between, so you don't want it flickering the whole time. And threshold will leave as is. So that should get us going. And as you can see, it's driving parameter ratio, and the values are from 0 to 100. So let's just see what happens if I run this. Actually, let's see this a bit better.
I never can say goodbye. No, no.
Okay, so I don't want it moving at all at the beginning here. So I'm going to have to adjust something to stop this from starting straight away. And that's basically the range, right? So the bottom range is too low at the moment. So what I'll start to do is push this up while it's playing in this part to see when it no longer reacts.
I never can say goodbye. No, 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 I never can say.
So 340 seems pretty good. Now we go to the high bits and do the same with the maximum frequency. And we'll probably be pulling it down because, to be honest, you know, it's only like an octave and a bit jump. So the frequency is only doubled. So if we're going from 340, it's probably going to be in the 600s, high 600s, that range.
Love him more and more. Tell me why. Is it so? Don't want to let you go. Hey, I know.
Yeah, 650, 660, probably be it.
I never can say goodbye. No, 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 I never can say goodbye. Every time I think I have had enough and start heading for the door, there's a very strange vibration piercing me right to the core. It says, turn around, you fool. You know you love him more and more. Tell me why. Is it so? Don't wanna let you go. Hey, I never can say goodbye, boy. Oh, baby, I never can say goodbye. No, 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 no.
Okay, pretty good. Now, there's one last thing I want to adjust because you may have noticed it's still a bit twitchy, a bit jumpy. That is in the actual multi-parameter window. Multi-parameter is being controlled by this knob, basically. But what's interesting is you have a speed control. So if I was to increase the speed control, it means that if I was to move the multi-parameter manually, it doesn't do it instantly. Watch, I'll put it like to 4 seconds. See how it slowly moves between? So I can whip it up and it's going to take 4 seconds to get there. Whip it down. And it's going to take 4 seconds to get down. So let's make this half a second, say. And see how that looks.
It says, turn around, you fool. You know you love him more and more. Tell me why.
Yeah, I think that's it. So there you go. This is one of the reasons I love melded production plugins, because this feature is in most of their plugins, like especially the multiband ones. And there's a lot more channels of it as well. So you can go mod crazy and multi-parameter crazy. And when it says multi-parameter, it actually does mean that. So this ratio could be controlling. If say I had 10 controls I wanted to adjust here, it could be driving all of them, right? I could have the volume happening as well as the panning if you wanted for whatever reason, all triggered from the pitch changes. Completely mad, I know, but point is, if you can do it, why not try? I'll save this patch and put it on a link below. Okay, hopefully you found this interesting, if nothing else, and I'll see you soon.